please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
One thing, you know, this idiom that blood is thicker than water, I think that clearly was the case yesterday with the Ambani brothers deal, and that too on the birthday of Dhirubhai Ambani. Yeah. So that of course was the talking point. But I think, look, on the market, one thing is clear that we are now in a range, and what it looked like on Wednesday that the market was breaking out was a bit of a false breakout. This market lacks triggers to, you know, break out. It will get its trigger maybe and break out, but for now the broader range is 10,450 to 10,450. They have been the contours for last 2 days, the high and low. If you just see the data on the NSE, the Nifty high and Nifty low have been in this range for last 2 days. The problem for the market right now is the Bank Nifty. Now, it's up 40% this year, but in last 5 months, it's up 1%. So all the gains for the Bank Nifty were front-loaded. January to July, we had a 39% rally. July onwards, we have had a 1% rally in the Bank Nifty. So you could divide the year in two halves, first 6 months and the last six months.
Isn't that true even for the Nifty, that a bulk of the gains are front-loaded?
No, they were, but for the Nifty at least, you know, it's been more sort of... because the Nifty gains are only, you know, 25. I'm saying only because in comparison to the Bank Nifty and the mid cap index. But for the Nifty also, of course, we went to 10,000, and after that, but still from 10,000 to 10,500, it's, you know,
actually comes to 5%. But then it did very well in the first part of the year.
So you know, the limited point here is that the biggest component of the market is struggling a bit, and it's struggling despite, you know, stocks like HDFC Bank doing reasonably okay. ICICI did reasonably okay yesterday. I think the PSU banks clearly is a bit of a problem for the market. A couple of others like Kotak, IndusInd at higher levels do see selling pressure, Axis for example. So what do you do in a market like this? Again, it's a market which is not falling. So it's gone up 1%. But the mid-cap index, they've had a secular run. Even this month, the mid-cap index is up 5.5%. And 2017, it's up 46%. Bit of a dangerous game, but you got to take some risks in equity markets. So I still believe that you got to go and buy mid-caps. And maybe hedge yourself, have risk management in place. For today, maybe commodities could be the space once again to focus on, because copper prices, aluminium prices are rising. And you got, you know, decent plays here to play. So I think that would be the place to be in. I think 2018 really is interesting when we'll have that cross platforms that we were discussing yesterday.
Oh yes, yeah. The integrated.
You could trade metals, you know. So on a day you want to just straight away trade metals and not get into the business of, you know, finding
stocks.
A proxy of, you know, Hindalco, Nalco and all. You could straight away play. I think that really is going to be interesting.
Oh,